Thanksgiving dinner, my grandmother asked me, what the heck is this Bitcoin stuff anyway, right? And I said to her, do you remember when Visa cards first came out? You were used to paying with cash or with a check, and then a Visa came out. It was this weird payment system that you didn't understand. And she said, yeah, I remember that. Well, Bitcoin is just the next evolution of another payment system.
Brace yourself, Nakamoto was the foundation.
What up guys, Nakamoto Crypto here. Cardano is going to make a lot of people rich just a few months from now. The next hard fork combinator event for Cardano will take place this month in mid-December and will implement a new token locking system. Now this token locking will be the basis for smart contracts and the creation of native assets in addition to ADA. IOHK, the software company behind the development of Cardano's ADA, informed just a few days ago that the upcoming hard fork combinator will take place in mid-December. This will introduce the new token locking function and take the mainnet to another step towards the Gorgon era. Yes, we are getting closer and closer to Gorgon. Internally, this stage of development is also known as Allegra, which was named after Lord Byron's daughter. After the integration of the metadata in the mainnet, token locking will be the next major upgrade for Gorgon, according to IOHK. This is a relatively small technical change to the consensus protocol, which has a minor impact on the actual ledger. However, it is significant because it prepares the platform for smart contracts to come in and also native asset creations in addition to the ADA token. As Mr. Kevin Herman, the software developer at IOHK, explains, token locking is a way of recording that a particular token is being used for a particular purpose. Locking in this case means that a certain number of tokens are reserved for a certain period of time so that they cannot be sold to gain an advantage. This can be, for example, a form of a vote or the execution of a smart contract. Hammond compares the process of token locking being equivalent to earning dividends from shares, stating that, for example, a person who buys shares in a company might be rewarded with dividends from the company's profits. Let's assume that this dividend is paid at the end of each calendar year and requires the shareholder to hold their shares for the entire year. If they were to sell some of their shares at the end of November, they would not lose the dividends for those shares that same year. They have entered a conditional contract with the share provider that gives them something of value in return just for holding a specific token, and thus for a certain amount of time. The locking of tokens is therefore indispensable for the realization of complex smart contracts. In addition, token locking is also an important component for the fifth and final development phase of Cardano, Voltaire, as it provides the basis for the future of voting mechanisms. Under the Voltaire mechanism, which will be used for the first time in the voting on the Catalyst project, those ADA holders who wish to participate in the voting system must lock some ADAs. This will provide that individuals have a certain number of votes, while the holder can continue to participate in the staking platform. The introduction of token locking will take place behind the scenes for ADA holders, as the Daedalus and Euro wallets will be automatically updated. However, the nodes on the network must download and install the new version of the code in order to agree and reach a consensus. According to Hammonds, after the implementations of the token locking system in mid-December, a further hard fork combinator event for multi-assets and other smart contracts functions will soon follow. Therefore, over time, this will lay the foundation for the creation of native tokens on the Cardano blockchain. He states that we are in the final stages of quality testing and will start the testnet deployment process this month, with an expectation of moving to the mainnet around mid-December. during 2021, there will be more and more upgrades using this combinator. Multi-asset support is also coming up as the Cardano platform continues to fulfill its potentials. On the same note, Ethereum Fund is due to debut on the Toronto Stock Exchange. As you all know, Ethereum was created by Vitalik Buterin back in the days in Ontario, Canada. And now, many years later, after the success of Ether, Ethereum is now available to all Canadians in the form of an ETF. Next week, the Canadian Digital Asset Investment Manager 3iQ will be launching an IPO of an Ethereum Exchange Traded Trust. The maximum offering for the launch is $100 million, and the closing date for this offering will be no later than December 10th. 3iQ counts for more than $400 million under management at the moment, and also maintains a focus on Bitcoin, Litecoin, and now Ethereum. In a press release on Thursday, 3iQ noted that this listing comes with a patriotic backstory. The concept of Ethereum was developed way back in 2013 in Canada and subsequently launched by a group of technologists from all over the world. Ethereum's co-founder and figurehead is actually Canadian-Russian, and his family moved to Toronto, Canada when he was only 6 years old. Traders of the South Canadian borders have demonstrated a remarkable appetite for publicly available Ethereum investment vehicles, despite a price premium which at some points crept upwards of 500% relative to the net asset value for the ETHE. Grayscale's Ethereum Trust, the digital asset, reports that more and more investors have been joining in. These funds are actually the preferred investment methods for many traders who are unable or unwilling to provision their own cryptocurrency custody and security options. Additionally, traders have enjoyed new offerings across the globe in recent months. In November alone, gold giant VanEck launched a Bitcoin exchange traded fund in Germany. The VanEck's Bitcoin ETN and 3iQ also introduced the Bitcoin fund to Canada. And lastly, Bitcoin will reach $50,000 in 2021, according to a Bloomberg analyst. A new crypto outlook for Bloomberg suggests that BTC could reach $50,000 in 2021, topping off a month of major institutional momentum for the asset. So this bull market is being driven and will be driven in the future by institutional investors shifting the center of the industry from East Asia to North America, winning converts from major research houses and institutions, driving the prices of BTC to new all-time highs. This is the rally for the banks and the big financial institutions, not just retail, which tells you that Bitcoin is gearing up for something big next year in 2021. Like the video, share, subscribe for some daily crypto content. I have been Mr. Nakamoto Crypto, and I'm out.
Bitcoin under $8,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin under $5,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin over $10,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin is over $20,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin under $8,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin under $5,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin is over $10,000.
Buy it.
Bitcoin is over $20,000. Best performing asset in the last 10 years.
True.
Look into crypto, we need volunteers.
Uh-huh.
No need to tiptoe, it won't disappear. Do your research, history made it clear.